prayers are with the families that have been affected by the tragedies over there in Paris. You know, we just played a good Michigan State team. Our kids gave a great effort once again. Defensively, we played well enough for us to win the ball game. Offensively, we continue to shoot ourselves in the foot with the turnovers. We had a promising drive in there, the first drive, putting the ball on the ground. We turned it over again in the passing game. And I'm going to tell you, man, Caleb Rowe and Perry Hills are trying to do everything we ask them to do. And I'm going to keep coaching those guys, and they're going to keep competing. You know, those two kids continue to fight. And, you know, they got to make some plays, but, you know, I'm proud that they show up and they put the work in. So their lack of execution isn't because of the lack of trying. And as a coach, as the guy that works with those guys on a daily basis, I got to get them to perform to the level in which our defense is performing. The kicking game hurt us early, you know, with those punts. And, you know, Schrader, you know, came in and punted for the first time in his career. First couple of punts weren't very good, and we wound up getting a hold of one. But, you know, these guys, as long as they continue to do the things that we ask of them as a coaching staff, I'm going to come in here and continue to praise them for their effort and praise them for the them sticking together through some tough times. We just played five really good teams, and then we got an opportunity next week with our last home game for the seniors at Bird. And I promise you, the Turk team that shows up next week is going to show up fighting mad, ready to play, and I'm gonna get them coached up.
It seems like there was that pick six, that was kind of the turning point. Would you kind of agree with that? It was 7-7 at that point, and then.
Yeah, I mean, obviously all those turnovers are critical for a team that's really struggling on the offensive side of the ball. I'd say that the fumble, you know, the fumble by Wes there, you know, it wasn't even Wes's fumble, he actually got hit in the mesh. Defensive tackle came off, and the timing of that play was a little off, so Wes never really had the ball. But, you know, any turnover that we have is critical for us on the offensive side because, you know, we have very little margin of error on that side of the ball. And, you know, we got to keep working with these guys to not turn it over and give themselves a chance to win the ball game. And today we didn't do that.
Is coaching turnovers out of players one of the hardest parts?
It is because when they step in between those white lines, you can't make them make the right reads. You can't, you know, it's not a video game where you can push the button and do those things. So, you know, we just continue to work on it in practice. We do ball security circuit, you know, on Wednesdays, and we're constantly preaching about it. You know, the interceptions today, you know, again, we threw the double coverage there right before the half, and it was just an egregious interception there because, again, with double coverage, you throw the ball outside or you throw it away. And, you know, like I said, those two guys, the quarterbacks, I mean, they're trying to do everything I ask them to do. I promise you that. And I got to get them coached up and get those guys to be able to execute it once they step inside the white lines the way they're coached to do it.
You've played Ohio State and Michigan State real tight and everything, close games and everything. And what's the general mood of the team? You know, they don't think they can play with you for a while, but.
Well, we got a team of fighters now. I promise you that. And these guys aren't going to ever turn and lay down and turn over for nobody. That's what we're developing. That's the mentality that we're going to have. You know, nobody's feeling sorry for themselves in that locker room. I know on the defensive side of the ball, they should have quite a bit of confidence in that. The last four or five games, you know, with the adjustments we've made and being very aggressive, we've given ourselves an opportunity to be in games against some really good teams. The offensive side of the ball has kind of been, you know, inconsistent. And again, it starts with the turnovers. And once we can try to find a way to minimize those things, then that's when you'll see us turn the corner. But, you know, we're close, and I do believe that, like I said, there's a nucleus of players in there that'll have quite a bit of success here in the near future, just a few pieces away, and we'll keep banging at it for the next game. Again, it's a game against a good Indiana team. It's at home, it's for our seniors, and like I said, we have no quitters in that locker. Those guys will fight for that victory next week.
Coach.